The world of TikTok might just be a confusing place to some. Not the least of which is because you might wonder how much a simple app went and spawned all sorts of creative people to jump on it and make lots of money off of it. As most will tell you, it's a mix of being in the right place at the right time, going and getting yourself noticed, and staying noticed once you have fame. But just like all other kinds of social media, if you do something wrong, people are going to call you out for it. So, allow us to show you 5 TikTokers who were forced to quit. Be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. 5. The Hype House. At one point in time, The Hype House was one of the biggest names in all of social media. In short, this was a group that formed with various TikTok, Instagram, and YouTube stars that was made with the purpose of growing their fan bases and attention by having everyone be in one house and working together. That way, their fan bases would converge, if you will, and as a result of that, they would be able to go and get more money off of their videos, posts, and more. And for a time it worked, and they had all sorts of big stars like Addison Rae, the D'Amelio sisters, and more. But in 2020, things started to unravel in major ways. Founding member Daisy Keach went and left the house and accused fellow founders Thomas Petrow and Chase Hudson of hogging all the rewards, trying to control all the other house members and more. She even noted that she helped put $18,000 down to help get the house itself, and yet she didn't get anywhere near the money back that her male founders did. As if that wasn't enough, a very loud breakup between Charli D'Amelio and Chase Hudson happened that brought two houses to war on Twitter. Since these two incidents, multiple members have left Hype House and you don't hear about it as much as you used to. 4. Tony Lopez. In August, Tony Lopez was accused of allegedly soliciting nudes from underage girls and sending explicit messages on social media. As a result, Tony was dropped by Bliss Spa, a spa and cosmetics company who said they would no longer sponsor or collaborate with Tony. After initially remaining silent on the matter, the 21-year-old tweeted a Notes app apology addressing the accusations and insisted he's not proud of his past choices. He said, "Once I found out the truth, I immediately stopped. I know these actions are not taken lightly and were extremely irresponsible of me. As a young man, I hold myself responsible for this mistake. Rather than run from it, I will learn from it to help better educate myself for now and for the future. I promise I will make better, well-informed decisions." You can make of that what you will. 3. The pandemic parties. In August, coronavirus cases in California reached alarming heights, and the public was urged to stay home to stop the spread of the virus. But what did Bryce Hall and Blake Gray decide to do? Throw a number of influencer-filled pandemic parties, of course. Bryce's packed 21st birthday party showed people crammed into his Los Angeles mansion without masks. Police arrived and shut the party down, but that didn't deter them. The pair threw several parties throughout the month, and authorities even had to cut off their water and electricity supply to stop the parties. Eventually, Bryce and Blake were charged with violating Los Angeles County's Safer at Home order, which prohibited large gatherings. Blake and Bryce weren't the only TikTokers guilty of throwing influencer parties, though. YouTubers Tana Mago, Jake Paul, James Charles, Nikita Dragon, and TikTok sisters Charli and Dixie D'Amelio have all been called out for attending crowded parties during the pandemic. They should have known better, but they didn't for some reason. 2. Bella Poarch's tattoo. This one is a bit tricky. You see, Bella Poarch had a meteoric rise to fame in 2020 and everything was going well, until she went and got a tattoo in the style of a Japanese rising sun emblem. When she revealed this, many Korean follows blasted her as the symbol she got is one of oppression and imperialism. She took a big hit in popularity for this, and as soon as she could, she got the tattoo altered so that it wouldn't look like that anymore. She also apologized, as she said she didn't know the history of the tattoo itself. Number 1, the D'Amelio sisters. When it comes to TikTok as a whole, there are always going to be someone or some group that went and ascended to the top of the platform if you want to be the most viewed or talked about person. And for the platform of TikTok, that would be Charli D'Amelio. She did various dance videos and quickly rose to the top. Her sister, Dixie D'Amelio, also grew to have quite a fan base as well. And the sisters went on to have great success no matter how you look at it. So, how was it that they were forced to quit TikTok in a certain way? Simple, they caused a major controversy, and as said controversies began to pile up on them, they decided that TikTok wasn't as fun as it used to be. It's extremely difficult to continue posting on a platform where the people that are watching your videos don't actually like, want to see you, and a lot of the feedback is negative. It's very hard to do that, Charli D'Amelio said, and I just kind of lost the passion for it because it used to be really fun for me. She said having such a large audience means everyone is ready to jump and criticize whenever she makes a mistake or something is taken the wrong way. That's why I don't speak as much besides the podcast because it's scary, she said. She has stated that she won't leave TikTok, more than likely because of the money it gives her. But she clearly looks at the platform differently now. But what incident caused all of these feelings and distancing? It happened in the premiere for their new Dinner with the D'Amelio series that is being featured on their recent launched family YouTube channel. The TikTok star sat down with their parents, Mark and Heidi, and their first mystery guest, YouTube star and beauty influencer James Charles. The meal was prepared by Chef Aaron May. While Mark was introducing Aaron, Charli made faces and sarcastically clapped her hands. She also made faces as he described the meal he was serving them. However, Dixie's behavior was even more appalling. She picked up a piece of food off of her plate and made faces as she pulled it apart. Dixie then sniffed what was in her hand and mimed gagging. "What is that?" she mouthed, prompting a confused James to ask what everyone else was laughing at. "What is this?" Dixie repeated, holding up the piece of food in her hand. "It's mushroom," her dad said, but she wouldn't let it go. "No, it's not. That's a snail," she insisted. The chef confirmed that it actually was a snail, and Dixie threw her head back in disgust while her sister's jaw dropped. What followed was a series of events that showed both Dixie and Charli being rude to the chef, throwing up, and acting as if the chef was trying to poison them with the food. While we're sure they found it funny, the community at large did not, with many viewers and critics lambasting the D'Amelio sisters for their antics. In the days following the release of the video, Charli lost more than 1 million followers on TikTok, and on November 19th, she shared an emotional live stream responding to the backlash. While the live stream was not available on any of her social media, fans recorded and shared the clip. "I feel like it was all just one huge misunderstanding, and like, I'm sorry, but I think it's completely blown out of proportion," she said through tears. "No matter what I say, no matter how I handle any of this, people are still going to think what they're going to think, and that's fine. Because those are the people who, in the long run, weren't going to be there for me at the end of the day, and that's fine. I understand that." Clearly she doesn't. She made her first major controversy, and her reaction is to say, "People made this bigger than it should have been?" That's honestly not your call to make. And not only was what you did to your personal chef disrespectful, calling out people who called you out for being a rude and disrespectful person is just as bad. It's true that Charli D'Amelio and her sister Dixie are still queens on TikTok. But they definitely aren't as universally beloved as this incident and others that followed it showed that they're not as down to earth as we were led to believe. So, what do you think? What do you think of this look at the TikTok members who were big on the platform in their own way, but then their own antics, messages, and more forced them to leave the service? Can you believe that some of these people were that reckless with their use of the platform? What ones did you used to follow before they were made to leave? Do you know another exile from TikTok that would fit on this list? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on the channel.